People, welcome back to Politics Watch. Now, can somebody tell me what going on in Manchester? A.K.A. Gelchester. Matter of fact, they must go lose a name there right now. Based on what going on. Right? Because it seems like the real name them forget down there is the Young Gelchester. Because from the start of the year, there has been 9 rape bull cases in Manchester, the great, great Manchester. But the disturbing fact is that of the 9 reported cases of rape bull activity, 4 of the victims are between the ages of 4 and 15. Let me say that again. Of the 9 cases of rape bull activity in Manchester, the victims start from the age of 4 to 15. That's in almost half of the cases. Victims start from the age of 4. Yo, how are going on in Manchester? How kind of dopey set loose down in Manchester? AKA Young Gelchester. Because I can't believe what I'm seeing. The great Manchester, a goat like this. I mean, the only positive is that there are only 9 cases. But then, the thing that the policeman emphasized is that there are only 9 reported cases. So, there's no way you're going to tell me, say, there is only 9 rapeable down in Manchester. Especially for the whole year, because we're in, basically, we're in July now. That's 6 months gone. So, clearly there's some kind of underreporting going on down that side. And we know underreporting of rape bull activity in Jamaica is terrible anyway. A lot of cases don't even make it to the station. Right? But, start from the age of 4, and the remaining 5 cases, the victims are between the age of 16 and 20. So that means across the full spectrum, of these nine victims, the youngest was 4 and the oldest was 20. A 20-year-old is still a young person, just done them teenage years. So from 4 to 20 in all cases, so that means not a single person who became a victim of rape bull activity in Manchester this year is over the age of 21. No man, the name change right now. No more Gelchester. It's Young Gelchester down the name now. Right? And I know some people will get vexed from Manchester. But I'm sorry, this is disturbing. Manchester is a place I'm rate highly. But this is very disturbing news. Right? All 9 reported cases. The people I'm young. From disturbingly young to official young. From 4 people are 4-year-old. Come on, people. Manchester. What going on there? Anybody who, any of my subscribers, any of the viewers them who are listening to this now, come from Manchester, tell me what going on there. Right? And as I said, the fact that there are only 9 reported cases, that alone tells me there's something wrong, because there's clearly some underreporting going on, because there's no way there's only going to be 9 cases in 6 months. And all 9 cases, people are very young. It seems like the younger people are more willing to speak up. Right? But this is a very disturbing trend, people. And you remember the incident with the 11-year-old who did get drawn away by the 16-year-old boy? That was also in Manchester, you know? Right, so that was Manchester. So it seems that there's some kind of disturbing. That's why I wonder what kind of dopey set loose down there. Right, because the case that I reported on, when everybody was traumatized to hear, say, 11-year-old I get drawn away by 16-year-old after school. Right, well now apparently it gets even worse, because we even have 4-year-olds down there now. I get Jarvey, 4-year-old? What the hell is a man doing with a 4-year-old? It don't even make sense to my head. Boy, I don't know what's going on. I don't know, this is disturbing. Right. The reason why I had to do a video on this is because Manchester, as I said, Manchester is a place that I rate highly. What I don't understand, how you can only have 9 reported cases of rapeable activity, and all 9 the victims range from the extremely young to the young. What? So the rapeable in Manchester no one no big woman or what? I don't understand what I want. Manchester is a place, from what I remember, where people used to look out for each other and police themselves. That's how Manchester used to run. But I guess those days are done now. Right? Because all these 9 cases are gone. We don't hear about nobody I deal with it. All of the men in Manchester will claim them are the most shatters. Them are the most thugs. We don't hear said the man them who that this 4-year-old case, when I hear say nothing to the man. Nothing here nothing to the 15-year-old. The man drive with the 15-year-old. So there needs to be some accountability down there in Manchester. I know people are gonna say, yeah, well, Kingston, St. Andrew and St. Catherine, all of this happened and worse. Okay. I am not denying that. This is not a competition for who can be the biggest rapable and have the most cases. What I'm saying is, if you have one parish with 9 cases and all 9 cases, the victims are range from the extremely young to the young. And not only that, but it's, you're seeing a trend where the cases are even more disturbing as they go down the line. It warrants some attention, so I don't want people to feel like I'm picking on Manchester. Like last time I do a simple video on Trelawney saying, just running to a joke that Trelawney just get them first stoplight. Man coming at the comment section, weeping and mourning and gnashing of teeth, saying I fight out Trelawney. People, don't be foolish. Don't be silly. As I said, I just need to know why Manchester, aka Galchester, soon to be called Young Galchester, right, is going down this path. Right. A 7-year-old get drawn away by a 57-year-old on June the 12th in Manchester. Let me say that again. A 7-year-old child, June the 12th this year in Spalding, a 7-year-old get drawn away by a 57-year-old. People, all the numbers, the numbers don't match. The physical structure of the two don't match. What is going on down here in Manchester? And this is following up rightly after the 11-year-old get jailed by the 16-year-old. So this is why I had to jump on this, because there's a trend, and this is how crime in Jamaica works. When one savage do something, and next man get motivated to tap it, and then within a short space of time, you see 6, 7, 10, 20 cases will just look familiar. There's a lot of copycat crimes in Jamaica. So what I'm worried about is that no other man are going to start get idea. See? Because the first one to really shock me down there was when we were about the 11-year-old and the 16-year-old. But now, see, our next man I try to tap that now, because a 57-year-old, see, draw away a 7-year-old, right? I mean, I don't know, these kind of cases are disturbing for me to report on. It don't make sense to me, right? And now, after the 57-year-old and the 7-year-old, the latest case that the police are hearing about is the report of a 4-year-old. So you see what I'm talking about? It only gets worse and worse. This is how some of these barbarians who live in our country operate. Them hear something and them go, what? 11-year-old, alright, look what me I got to know. And them go on a 7-year-old. Then a next barbarian hear 7-year-old and go, what? 7-year-old? Me can't be better than that. Watch out now, 4-year-old. And next thing you know, you descend into outright Sodom and Gomorrah, and all kind of barbarism. Manchester people, talk to me in the comment section. What going on there? Something at the water hour. This is Politics Watch. Like, comment, share, and tell me what going on. Bless you.